Hey guys, this is Junior Trader, and in this video we have a lot to cover. Guys, there is a lot of breaking news on Nvidia and AMD. We'll take a look at that and then we'll jump into price action as well. So this video is dedicated to Nvidia and AMD, and if time allows we'll take a look at some of the other semiconductors as well. But let's jump right into some of the articles and some price targets upgrades that have happened. Now the very first article I want to go over is a sensible one. Well, I don't know what is sensible right now, the price targets of Nvidia, but this thing is going parabolic in the price action. And, you know, the analysts are catching up onto that. So let's cover this one first. It's a very quick one. So Cantor Fitzgerald initiates Nvidia with overweight rating. Price target is $775. Nvidia has an average rating of buy and price targets ranging from $410 to $1,100. Now, this is another price target upgrade that came on Nvidia this morning. And there is one ludicrous article as well I want to go over real quick. And that is how to earn $500 a month from Nvidia stock. This is a little bit crazy. So let's go down straight over here. So as Sunil Gupta, CEO and co-founder of Yota, shared that the order includes nearly 16,000 NVIDIA H100 and GH200 AI chips with delivery expected by March 2025, Reuters reported. And this is for the part being that NVIDIA, meanwhile, is looking to boost its AI chip sales in India significantly through a deal with Yota, an Indian data center operator. So this goes to show that there's, you know, deals coming ahead of the times for Nvidia and some other companies as well. But here's the funny thing, that the article that it says how to earn $500 a month from Nvidia stock, and they say based on their current dividend you would need approximately 22 million worth of Nvidia shares to generate an income of $500 per month. And that is, they just want a catchy headline. Again, you get the point. And even with the, you know, the 100 shares over here, you can see that for, 100 dividends, you will still need somewhere north of 4 million worth of shares of Nvidia. But you can, guys, better you could just go and get some other dividend, you know, income paying stocks, which have dividend yields from 7 to 10% as well. But yeah, that was just more of a ludicrous article I just wanted to cover. It's just funny. And here are some of the other articles that analyst says Nvidia stock could undergo Apple-like transformation with focus on software and services. Nvidia could be on a brink of an Apple-like transformation as it shifts focus to software and services rather than just the hardwares. Other than that, just go and summarize all in all what's been being talking about in the newsphere. But that's something on Nvidia, guys, I want to cover. Most importantly, we had the price target upgrade on Nvidia. I'll talk about the price action visiting Nvidia just in a second, but I want to cover some of the AMD news as well first. So here we go. AMD stock has a lot more room to rise, analyst cites AI opportunity. On Tuesday, analyst Matt Bryson reiterated his outperform rating for AMD shares and raised his price target for the chipmaker to $200 from $130. It has to be because price is way above $130. And Wedbush has been arguing that AMD is best positioned to serve as a second source alternative to Nvidia for some time. And that is correct. After Nvidia is only AMD, guys, that is well suited. So, and then analysts go on predicting that AMD will generate blah, blah, blah. Cool stuff. They have their positions. That's what it tells, that analysts have bought somewhere down at the bottom here. Now it's just pumping it up. When I say pumping it up, I mean, so valuation is all based off of what the sentiment is, the consensus is, right? So, but that was one of the, you know, the items. And then this is the same thing. We have Wedbush raise AMD's price target to $200 from $130. Already I covered that. And AMD is coming with their earnings, guys, next week? Yeah, Tuesday, 30th of Jan. So coming soon, right? But so let's cover the price action. So now let's cover some technicals. And I want to start off with AMD and then we'll jump on to Nvidia, okay? Because since we are already on AMD here. So AMD has been going into this parabolic move. It's all pretty much at all-time highs, and there's one level that I can just, yeah, that's where the levels are as well, guys. This was $164. And Nvidia, sorry guys, if I said Nvidia before as well, AMD has seemed to found this support again at the all-time, recent previous all-time high, which is $164.53. Now, AMD is in a, you know, parabolic move. I don't suggest trading around earnings, but seems like AMD might start to stagnate here. Again, it's not bearish, even if it gives you some cool off, but this will be the, I think, 174 to 175 is where AMD may start to cool off a little bit. And why I say that is because, let's go to the hourly interval and I'll show you why. So we have a region formed where sellers are present, at least in the near price action. This is your zone. Now, this could be a zone if you are looking for 2-3 days out of play. This could be a shorting zone, but have a stop loss above 174.50 or something. You have to have your stop loss above that somewhere if you're building a short position. But until where can that cool off happens? I'm not counting anything more below $160 for now. $160 only, and then that's where I feel AMD can still go up. Definitely there's a confirmed play below 164 for the bearishness. And also if AMD stays below $170. So if today you see AMD close around 167 below 20 and 50 hours moving average as well, tomorrow can again be a play to 164 and then down to 159. Otherwise, AMD has a room to run to 174, but that's where I feel like some sell-off may also happen. Again, this is only the place until before earnings, not after earnings, in my opinion, or during earnings. Then after earnings, we'll see how the price action is doing after earnings, and then we'll catch up from there. But I feel like this is the exhaustion move that AMD may give up here, at least the cool-off. Some in the parabolic moves until earnings. I don't think 175 above it will go. Again, if it goes, you have to have your stop loss. But my hunch is that at least it may stagnate here or give some range bound plays or some lower plays. Not too low, but some cool off maybe until the 20 days moving average catches up. So, all right, Nvidia. So guys, Nvidia is full on still parabolic. We have been covering about this. You know, this parabolic move we talked about. This is still a parabolic continuation move. Why? Because I'm not seeing a sell-offs here. I can also pop on the short volume percent here. And guys, as I'm covering this content on my video with the levels and all these, you know, things that I cover, my day trading bots, my indicators, all these are part of my memberships as well. I also have Wall Street alerts like price targets, real-time upgrades comes there as well. Then insider trading, news and sentiment upgrades and downgrades. As I said, elite, day trading bot, basic membership, my indicators. Links are in the description below to my memberships. Also, if you happen to join for 6 months, you have a discount as well. And then my Discord link is also in the description below of this video, guys. So, in case you are interested. Okay, now, what do we have here is Nvidia at the short volume data that I have plugged it on. So, 28.27, considerably still a, you know, higher than 24%, but it's not that as high as we were getting here at 31-32%. Nvidia is mostly owned by institutional investors, not much by day traders. So if you see a high short volume percent coming, which was at 31-32, that means some of the institutions are trying to short it, okay? Because it's mostly owned by institutions. Now, technically, as I said, we are still in the parabolic move and we are seeing less short volume as compared to 30 and 32 come up here. But it's not that concerning. It is high, but not that concerning. Why? Because Nvidia is in the parabolic move and all these short sellers are fueling up to the upside because as it breaks the one level up, the short seller starts covering, that creates another fuel up to the upside, right? But what is the price action telling us on Nvidia? So let's talk about that. Let me turn this volume off and let's go to the hourly interval and let's talk about that. So Nvidia, guys, is not doing a proper cool off. Well, it is trading in our levels. So it went to the 585. You can turn off, if you want to see more clarity, you can turn off, well, when I say more clarity, if you want to see where the price action was yesterday, you can turn off self-adaptive level. It will go chronological. So our level was at 584.79. We came very close to that level, right? But beyond that, and let me actually just, yeah, that's fine. I'm just going to leave that right up there this way. Now, what we have, Nvidia is not still giving any proper cool off, right? It is being bought up again at these levels of support. So 584 at 50 days moving average, or sorry, 50 hours moving average. Nvidia, as I say, since it's been, you know, from 2 days, it's not giving cool off. It's again going sideways, just like it did over here, not selling off. And then we called out this and continuation of parabolic move and uptrend, uptrend, uptrend. Now it's again going sideways. And as if it explodes now above $600, guys, this is a continuation to the upside. Remember, when you see wicks like this getting bought up, that means buyers are present. Okay, Nvidia can go up. Sentiment shift can only start happening if Nvidia closes the day on hourly below 50. Then there's a chance or likelihood. Otherwise, this thing is still very strong to the upside. Yeah, it doesn't. Yes, it's extended. And I feel like this is where you should be taking some profits if you have positions. But yeah, this thing intraday, as I said, the level above $600 or even level above 596. Around this above 20 hours moving average, this can explode still higher. So yeah, it has a lot of strength to it, guys, still. Well, this is it for this video, guys. I hope you found it helpful and valuable. If you did, please hit the like and subscribe, and I'll see you in my next videos. Take care, guys. Bye.